What have you been up to?
I've been riding on a daydream.
Hey, YouTube, thanks for checking out RV Daydream, and it's the next morning. Heidi,
I'm freezing.
Heidi says she's freezing. I don't think it's too bad. It's 52, and it looks like this is going to be the high for the day. I thought it was going to be closer to 56, but oh well. Lots of leaves falling. I'm sure this is going to be snow shortly, but we'll be home by then. Tomorrow's supposed to be warmer, and then, of course, Friday will be really warm. Of course, Heidi will be at work, and then we get to go for our son's birthday tonight. We'll head back to the house, get some dinner. It seems odd not having water and stuff in the camper. We're starting to get used to that. But since we already winterized it, which I'm glad we did.
You won't have to hurry and when we get home.
Yeah. If I would have known that we were going to be able to get out and go camping, then I wouldn't have winterized it. We wouldn't have done all that work. So we could have had water today. But the shower house isn't that far away, which I'll show you guys here. Seen a lot of animals, like Cody had said. I saw a raccoon. There was a cat that was out here. There's black squirrels. I remember for a long time you could only see black squirrels over in Kent. They weren't really anywhere else in Ohio, but now they're everywhere. So what we're doing today is going to nibble on whatever food we've got inside there. I've been trying to upload day one video, and a combination of things. I captured it at too high a bit rate, as I mentioned on the last video near the end there. So I backed off the bit rate that the cameras captured. However, when I uploaded to YouTube, I had a pretty high bit rate still encoded that made it to where it uploaded for 7 hours, and it was only at 50%. And the video, you know, it's like a 20-minute video, but I had to redo everything. I went ahead and dropped the bit rate down to what YouTube recommends. So now I'm at YouTube recommended settings on this video that hopefully is uploaded okay. But I've got our Wi-Fi hotspot up in the window here, which I'll show you that in a second. And we're only getting 4 bars at the most, usually 3 bars though. So I'm going to have to check the campgrounds. Maybe Heidi and I can do a walk or something a little bit later. And we'll see if there's any point in the campgrounds that has solid coverage as far as Wi-Fi is concerned, because this isn't cutting it right now. I mean, I would, if it would make a big enough difference, I would actually think that it'd be smart to grab the hotspot and the laptop and go drive to that part of the park and just let the video upload if it goes relatively quick. So I told her that's, of course, just going to cost money at some point. That means it's going to have to be a wee boost to boost the cellular signal, because right now, even our phones, we're real spotty. We'll drop down to no bars, 2 bars, 4 bars, 1 bar, 3 bar, and it just bounces all over the place. So I don't know what that means. I don't know why that's the case. So we'll have to see. Maybe it's just a characteristic of this part of the park. I'll try to get online and see if I can find something that shows a map and coverage, and see if we're on a fringe. Maybe that might be the case. I just don't know. So let's see what entails for today. Here's that hotspot. You can see I got it on one of those SMA tree, SMA tree clamps that I've done a video on in the past. And this is where it's getting its best signal at. So hopefully that changes and it gets a little better. Of course, Heidi parked her car here, and then my truck set up there last night, which seems to be okay. The park rangers came by and they didn't even give it a second look. You can see how close we are to the shower house. That makes it awful nice. It was really quiet out last night. I mean, eerily quiet. And I used the bathroom about, oh, I don't know, 1 a.m. I guess it was, or 1:30 a.m. And wow, was the moon just unbelievable. So this is a shower house, just like all the rest of the shower houses. These were updated in 2001 when Bob Taft was governor, and the plans were these were going to all be done this way. But that didn't happen. It's a little dark in here. I think the camera will adjust. So, love it. All these are private showers and automatic lights. So, when you just come in, they turn on the lights for you. Kind of nice. And then, of course, you got your laundry over here. You got a pop machine here. And then the two bathrooms, which we'll go into the men's bathroom here. I don't think anybody's in here. Yeah, real light and airy. But the sad part is they didn't do any of the other campgrounds as far as I know. This is the only one. So, darn it. But yeah, they always keep them pretty clean. You can see they're starting to get in disrepair because, again, it's been since 2001 when they built them. I think this makes the park, one of the reasons that this makes the park really nice. Of course, there's dryers on this side. And I wonder if Heidi's out here smoking, waiting for me. Nope. She ran back to the camper. She ran back to her car. She's leaving. That'd be funny. She starts that car and says, ciao. Yeah, these are all good sites. I mean, we could have parked right there. Hell, we could have parked even right here. Maybe we'll do that next time because, quite honestly, that site was kind of hard to level. So I'm going to have to remember number 5.
Fuck me out of the camper.
Oh, is that what's wrong?
Although we love our charcoal grill and we love cooking on the charcoal grill, we're finding out that you guys that are using these little gas grills that are just little propane bottle driven, not very big, you might be on the right path there as far as just for a single person or two people, like in our case, because I'm getting ready to start a fire and cook just to fire up some hot dogs for myself for lunch. And even though it's not too difficult, it's still a little bit of a process. See what this looks like. Yeah, how nice is that? So cherry red in there. Ooh, probably burning the new camera. That's all it takes to get the fire started. And man, those charcoal hot. So what I'm going to do is dump those hot coals down in the grate. You can just start the charcoal, obviously, inside of the grill, but it starts so much faster this way. So, they're ready. Let's go ahead and set you up so you guys can see. Get you a little closer. If we can get this thing poured in here without burning myself. The sizzle. Listen to the sizzle. One got away. All right, so they're all done. Looky there. So good. Okay, we're gonna let the grill burn off like Heidi said. Without her helping, I would probably have screwed this up. So now I'm gonna go in and get something to eat. Alright guys, so the sun's starting to come out, but it's only 50 degrees out. We are going to do a little bit of a walk because I'm kind of getting bored inside. I'm still trying to upload that video. Ugh, not real happy about that. I've never walked this loop and put it on video before. I don't know why. We always do the other loops, but we've never done this one, so here we go. Now this one is the winter loop, so this is open all year round. And then there's a couple of other places that are up here, and then there's some that are a little bit further away. All of them can be
had during the winter. There might be some wind that'll be coming through the microphone. I was going to go ahead and mic up Heidi and I, but for this walk, eh. But let me look at this one. This is site number 11. Look how short it is. It's tiny. I don't think that I could get my truck and trailer on here. Maybe. And the funny part is it would open up the wrong way. Wouldn't it? Yeah, the door would be on this side. Oh, well. All these sites are short, really short, but they are facing the water. That's kind of nice. So we'll walk a little bit further here. If the wind gets too bad on the camera, I'll just do a voiceover on it. This would be a big site. It's on a hill, an incline, I should say. But you'd have all this area if you needed it for whatever reason. I'm trying to catch up to Heidi. So we had a big diesel pusher that left here earlier, and it's more than obvious he's coming back because that's his Harley and all his stuff. He won't be here for very long. Everybody's probably going to leave the 18th. When does it say he's leaving? The 18th. Because we all know what's coming. I don't really care for these inside spots. You're so limited. But that is a long spot. And the slope's not too bad. It's a little tiny camper. It's probably about the size of ours. We just don't know it, huh? I don't know how easy it'd be to walk down there. Looks like it will be a handful. Heidi's thinking about it. She tried the walk down near our campsite, and she said she slid down the whole hill. Nice. I'm sure this water's really high. Whenever the lake's up. Or the reservoir, I should say. This wouldn't be a bad camping spot, I guess. I don't know. I like it much warmer than this. So all you guys know how I feel about the cold. This site's not too bad. Number 21. I hear a woodpecker up there. Listen. Oh, he just flew away. I like this one. So number 21, we'll have to remember that. I always try to mention the numbers because, to be honest, I've referred back to our videos more than a few times to try to figure out what sites, if they were open, we might want to go to. That is definitely a slippery slope right there. Mm-hmm. Now there's water supply over there. Well, that only works in the summer. But it'd work in a pinch, I guess.
That's right.
Yeah, 22. Kind of glad we got a chance to look at this loop. For us changing sides as a vehicle approaches. It's a race. You guys know how I feel about the speed limit. I talked about that in the video prior. What's the rush? Seriously. What could he possibly be needing to go do that he has to drive 25 miles an hour in a 10 mile per hour zone? You think I think 25 is probably pretty fair. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt. I say he was only going 15 miles per hour over the speed limit. So that's sites 6 through 22 that are open all winter. course, these are open too. So 23 for people that need wheelchair access, handicap, whatever. 24 is not bad. It would open up to the wrong side. So I like this one up here. This one's not too bad. A slope down and kind of leaning towards the driver's side, or the non-entrance side of the camper, but doable, right? And then this parking over here, obviously, you could use, like in our case. Yeah, this one's not too bad. I think that the next time we come down, even though we really don't have water view, I don't know. Although I like our site.
It'd be pretty shaded, it looks like.
Don't need that in the winter so much, huh?
Wow.
Lots of woods. That'd be nice. That'd be nice and private. This site would not be private at all. Yeah, it's short. Yeah. We do, no, we've done those loops down there. I don't know how many times. Yeah, we've done that loop down here tons of times. So we don't need to go there. It is a race. I guess stop means spin tires on pavement. Okay, so we had an issue. And that was what, Heidi?
Your battery went dead.
Heidi made my battery go dead. She clearly knew that I was trying to record a lot. And unfortunately, she decided that only one battery would be a good idea. I'm cutting through. We're going to get back to where we were. Oh, so that's nice. Heidi and I almost stepped in a landmine, a fresh landmine.
People, clean up your dog poop.
Sites 187 through 198. So that's where we're going now. These are all open all winter long. They're obviously electric only. It's not really a loop. It empties out into the other ones that are open. That's kind of nice. The only thing is that's the dump station right there. So that could be a plus or minus. The dump station is open all winter. So if you have some way to keep your stuff warm, I guess. These are walk-in sites. How about that? Look. So this means you cannot reserve these sites during the summer, in the peak of the season. Well, that's good to know. Right? So all these sites will always be open unless somebody's came in before you and taken them. I'm glad that we came down this loop. I didn't know that. It's a nice view there. This would be a nice site. Too short, but you got a good view of the water in the background. And of course, it comes up much higher during the summertime. You can see kind of where it's supposed to be. Just a pleasant view. So we're in the 190s here. All these are walk-in sites. At least all these right here. We'll go a little further. It's a camper host spot. Which, obviously, there's no camper host this time of year. But you can take their spots. They're walk-in. It's kind of nice. Again, real short, though. Very, very short. If you get on the website, they'll tell you how long the pad is and if it's sloped, if there's shade, and they usually show a picture of it too, right? Yeah, They show a picture of it, at least for this campground. So these sites here are not open except for primitive. There's no electric down there. So I think that 133 to 145, I believe they're open, but I think it's just for primitive. Looks like those are walk-in too. Of course, that's closed. What a shame. I wanted to go to the beach and swim today.
That's why.
These are all available right here. Somebody's got a tag on there. That site's pretty decent. It's not long, but it's a nice big site. This one's very short. This one's kind of short. Empties out into a wet area. Another little short site. And I backed into this site yesterday. Yeah, I turned around. So these are the loops that are open during the winter. Oh well. So Heidi and I had our walk. That's why we're leaning on the car. I'm a little too tired to even get the keys out to open the camper. I think Heidi will be taking a nap here shortly.
No, we gotta go home.
Oh yeah, we do. What time is it? I'll show you the view out here. You can see it. Looks kind of nice. It's kind of delightful. It's pleasant. It's only 3:30. I guess we could go. See if my video's uploaded yet. We're going to take a look here over the water real quick. It's a nice view. So we're probably going to be heading out shortly to go back to the house for our son. Heidi's getting some photos in, getting a cigarette in too. And then we'll, of course, close this thing out later. We're done for the evening. Heidi wanted to come up and use the restroom, and I was her escort. We had some birthday cake, which was Hershey pie, and we had ham and mashed potatoes and gravy and green beans. So now we're full. So I thought it'd be best to hurry up and get back here, so in case we decide to get a little tired, we could do so. So here's the deal. The videos are going to go up slowly because I have a video that is right now private. It did get uploaded. It was real slow to do so. I'm going to edit this video. Of course, that will go in next. And I'm not sure when you guys have seen this, but today is Thursday. Today is Wednesday. So Wednesday evening. So I would assume that they're probably going to get posted over the weekend, unfortunately. We have to figure that out. I think that the answer is going to have to be a Wi-Fi booster because... or a cell phone booster. I keep on saying Wi-Fi because it's definitely an issue.
At least here.
Yeah, I'm sure if we... I guess that's a tip that you guys may want to pay attention to whenever you're in a park and you're trying to find a spot. Don't only look for a good spot, obviously, but when you get to the spot, if there's maybe four or five that you haven't really set your mind to, maybe pull out your phone and see how many bars of service you have, because maybe one of those sites, if they're different than the others, like in this case, I know this park. I was looking at some maps when I was at home, whenever we had really good signal, and I could see that for the most part, there were parts of this park that were reported by customers to have better signals than other. It was a darker color on the map, so... And that wasn't from T-Mobile, that was from a third party. I think that was Open Signal, if I'm not mistaken. So, something to think about. But don't get me wrong, we have good data and good, it's just uploads. It, We have like 3 bars of 4G, which is fine for our browsing, and that's it, really browsing. But as far as uploading, you know, a 20-minute video, that didn't work out so good. It took quite a long time. So we're going to go back to the travel trailer. I'm going to do some video editing, and Heidi's going to do something. I don't know what. Probably fall asleep. All right, guys. So we'll pick it up later, and we hope to see you out there.
Bye.
Bye.